So now let's explore this database model over here. So we've got students, and then we have courses, and those students enroll onto courses. So we have another table called enrollments. If I now expand the student table, to keep it simple, we have only included student ID and the student name. And if we look at the courses, you can see it's just course ID and the course title. And for enrollments, all we have is the enrollment ID, the student ID, and the course ID. Notice that these are the primary keys over here. For courses, of course, the course ID is the primary key. For students, it's the student ID that's the primary key. So how do you work with this model where you have a relationship with one student can be enrolled onto multiple courses and one course would have many students enrolled onto it? So how do you work this data with the entity framework? It's actually very simple. So let's have a look at our classes. So here you can see we have a student class. We've got the two fields, student ID and name. Then we have course and we have the course ID and the title. Then we have enrollment and we have the enrollment ID, student ID, and the course ID. Now, in order for this to work with entity framework, what you have to do is each student can have multiple enrollments. So what you do is you declare another property in here to define that relationship. So here we're using I collection, and the collection is going to be of type enrollment. Now, notice what enrollment is. Enrollment is this class that we have created. It's got the enrollment ID, student ID, course ID. So that's what that lives within the student class. So basically think of it as like a list of courses that the student is enrolled into. So it's a one-to-many relationship. Then you have the courses. So here you've got the course selection. So again, here one course can have many students enrolled into it. So again, you say this is a list of enrollments this course is involved in. And then within the enrollment class, what you have is each enrollment could have a student. So one enrollment can only have one student and it can have one course because here you've got the enrollment ID and you've got the student ID and the course ID. So you can see why we have a collection here versus not a collection here, because this is an one to many relationship. This is that actually for each enrollment there can only be one student and one course. They cannot have duplicate enrollment ID. So this is the basic structure to set up your entity framework application. And then you can do stuff like this, which we will talk about at another time, but I'll run this so you can see what's going on. So here for John, we are picking out what courses is he enrolled into. And you can see John is enrolled into English Literature and Computer Science. Keep watching and we'll discuss more around this.